morning. My name is Daryl Higginbotham, and I'm president and owner of Marietta Non-Destructive Testing, and also Southern Polytechnic graduate in 1989. Our company, Marietta NDT, designs and builds all types of special machines for non-destructive testing of aircraft and automotive systems. People ask us, what is engineering technology and how does it fit into our business model? Quite simply, it's a link. It's the key link between the applied side of engineering to the theoretical side and then down to the manufacturing component. You really have to have all three groups to make it work. Engineering technology is that key link that works with mechanical engineering people and electrical engineering theory-based engineers with the applied of the machinist, the fabrication technician, and more importantly, the assembly team that puts the machines together and makes it work. Engineering technology is a wonderful way to make a living. Students studying engineering technology are instantly hired in industry. They are the problem solvers, the ones that can make it happen and get the job done.
I chose MET because it is a blend of mechanical engineering and the hands-on, what you would get at a technical college. This is like the perfect blend of being able to actually use your hands and be able to do the engineering side of it.
While going through the classes, I was making a lot of the samples that we were breaking. So it was just like, you know, I got the best of both worlds. I got to make them, got to break them, and now I'm actually getting paid to do the same thing.
I designed floor plans for the factory, took time studies, and all of the learning and training that I got in MET prepared me for it.
Maybe more hands-on. I'm always reluctant to say hands-on because it sounds like brains off. Yeah. And this is definitely not a brains off program.
We have a lot of great teachers here.
In engineering technology programs, we're required by our accreditation body to hire only faculty with significant industry experience. Where you'll typically find an engineering faculty that they went straight from graduate school into teaching with no real industry experience.
I have a PhD in mechanical engineering.
I work with piston manufacturer.
My bachelor's degree is in mechanical engineering and my master's in engineering mechanics.
And I have worked in the areas related to micro machinery.
Truck chassis manufacturing.
13 years of industrial experience in the aircraft and chemical industry.
We have four concentrations. Engineering design graphics, we have manufacturing, we have the thermal energy area, and we have machine design.
A race team, they have parts that they wanted manufactured. So the race team is machining those parts. They'll use that as an investment as far as a fundraiser. They'll machine the parts, provide them to the racing team, and then they're going to be selling them to other teams. The oil cap, that was initiated by a civil engineering student, and then our lab supervisor, Kevin Starks, worked on the design. Another faculty member in mechanical engineering technology worked on the project initially, and they actually brought in students from mechanical engineering technology to create the CAD models in SolidWorks, do the simulations that were eventually used and shown out in industry to people who wanted to invest in the product.
The MET program is challenging, but it prepares you for the corporate world, you know?